Hi guys, now in this section we will discuss another technique that is used to reduce harmonic content in the inverted power supply waveform, and the name of technique is pulse width modulated inverter. This is called pulse width modulation PWM. So in this technique, this is quite a simple technique. Like previous technique that we discussed uses a very large number of diodes and it is quite expensive. In this technique, we are using only 4 diodes, and by using the 4 diodes you can see this is forming single phase full bridge PWM inverter, and using these switches the waveform is produced phase voltage waveform of PWM inverter. The shape will be like this. So the output DC will be pulsated with some limited duration, like from alpha 1, alpha 2, 1 pulse, alpha 3 to alpha 4 second pulse, alpha 5 to onwards like third pulse, and 0, pi by 2 and pi, these are showing the angle, and WT is showing the phasor rotation. So it is simulating. In the start you can see the pulse width is small. So RMS equivalent for this small pulse will be less. So more and more number of pulses are generated. This is just a simplified waveform. We can generate hundreds and thousands of pulses to make this sinusoidal waveform more and more accurate, and in this way we are basically reducing the harmonic. This is the Fourier series of the quarter wave symmetrical M pulse PW waveform. This is the Fourier equation that we are using for pulse width modulation, and in order to calculate switching angle we are doing computation using following formula. So it's all mathematics. So using Fourier analysis and computation of the switching angles we are calculating by these equations. Here we can see a different modulation index. We can see the performance of pulse width modulation. For example, at 0.82 modulation index we are getting THD, total harmonic disorder is 38.22, which is fairly high, and when the modulation is increased then what is happening, that THD is increased. So this technique is useful, but still it has a very high THD value as compared to our previous technique DCMLI, where we were achieving up to 9, up in the range of 10%. So this is technique it's not recommended to use alone, but it can be used in conjunction with you can say PWM with the DCMLI. So we will discuss in our next slide. Thank you.